Right now, we're following more breaking news. A heat alert. We're experiencing the hottest temperatures in almost two decades.
Albuquerque hit the hundreds for a second time this year. First Alert meteorologist Byron Morton joins us live in northeast Albuquerque with why it's so hot. Hey, Byron.
Hey there, Shelley. Yeah, and only one other time in Albuquerque was it hotter than this. That was back on June 26, 1994, when we hit 107 degrees, and that was the hottest day ever. But today's 105 even started off sizzling.
Not even noon, and this sign says the temperature's already 97 degrees. New Mexico's summer sun sears every section of the Duke City. But according to people in Old Town, how hot it is all depends on where you're from.
It's way hotter than where we came from.
These folks from Oklahoma have no complaints about the heat.
It's dry and calm and no wind, and it's nice.
What if we ask a Texan?
Well, it could be a little cooler. Could be a lot hotter, too.
Seems to be indifferent. Surely this New Englander is hating the heat.
Oh, it's great.
No? But how could that be?
At 80 in Maine, you can't stand it.
And why is it so different?
Because of the humidity.
Perhaps the old saying, it's a dry heat, has some truth to it.
And this is typically the hottest time of year for Albuquerque, from June 25th to about July 14th. But for this incredible heat, why it is so intense is likely due to our dire drought. Think of it this way. You have a dry bottle and you have a bottle full of water. And the bottle full of water is going to heat up a lot slower than this dry bottle. Our ground here in New Mexico is like this dry and hot bottle. That's why it heats up so quickly. Reporting live from just outside the KOAT 7 studios, I'm First Alert meteorologist Byron Morton. Back to you.
When the temperatures get this hot, we all know you should not leave your kids or pets, of course, in the car. But that's not all. Experts say you should not store aerosol cans in areas that get above 120 degrees because they can explode. The heat can also change the chemical composition of prescription medications, so don't leave them in your car. For the rest of the list, go to KOAT.com and click on the main media window.